Hi. Welcome to our Sunday school lesson. This Sunday, the lesson is about Joseph. Remember that last Sunday it was about Joseph? Well, this Sunday we continue the story. So if you remember what happened to Joseph, the story last Sunday ended that his brothers sold him to a merchant that was going to Egypt. Well, so he was in big troubles now. He had big problems. That merchant went to Egypt and sold him as a slave. And there, Joseph got into big problems with his master, and he ended up in jail. When the story begins, he is already in jail, and we go then to Pharaoh. Pharaoh means king. So the kings in Egypt were called Pharaoh. So Pharaoh was having
make a pause here. Before watching this video, remember, there is always a first video. So if you have not watched video number one, I would encourage you to stop watching video number two and go to video number one, okay? If you did, let's continue the story. So Pharaoh was having very weird and frightening dreams. And the thing is that he didn't know what they meant. And that worried Pharaoh. One day, this slave was in charge of bringing the wine to Pharaoh. So he comes with the wine, and he knows what is troubling Pharaoh. And he says, well, I know this guy that was in jail with me. His name is Joseph, and he has the ability of discerning discerning dreams. That means knowing the meaning of the dreams. So he gets excited because, I don't know if you remember from the previous story, remember when he was bragging to his brothers about the dreams that he was having, like the 11 stars bowing to him? Well, God had given Joseph this wonderful ability, of discerning dreams. Just like God gives you and gives me different abilities. Well, Joseph's ability was to discern dreams, know what dreams meant. Obviously, he did it with the help of God. So this cupbearer tells Pharaoh about Joseph. And Pharaoh calls Joseph, calls for Joseph. And Joseph, and Pharaoh tells him about his dreams, and Joseph explains the dreams. Now, do you remember what the dreams were about? Very weird dreams. So the dreams were about cows and strands of wheat. What do you dream about? Usually I don't remember my dreams, but sometimes they're kind of crazy too. He had two dreams in one. The first one, do you remember what was it? a very healthy fat cow and a very healthy strand of wheat. Perfect. That was the first dream. But then a very skinny cow with a very scary, scary strand of wheat came. And he that worries him. He didn't know what that meant. And he called his helpers and they couldn't tell him a reason or the meaning of the dreams. And then he tells Joseph. And Joseph tells him that what the healthy, the fat cow and the healthy strand of wheat means is that in the next 7 years, Egypt is going to have a lot of food. The crops are going to be wonderful and they're going to have plenty to eat. The skinny cow and the very scary strand of wheat meant that after those awesome, great 7 years of a lot of food, there were going to come 7 years of no food at all, where the crops were going to be horrible and they weren't going to have anything to eat. So Pharaoh and his helpers decided that with Joseph's help discerning the dream, that they were going to prepare during those first 7 years, because they were going to have so much food that it was going to be enough to save enough food for the coming 7 years that they weren't going to have. So that's what they did. And when the 7 years came of bad crops, they had enough food to feed all Egypt. So in other words, Joseph had saved Egypt. That was awesome. He used his gift for something wonderful for the benefit of people. That's something that we should do. Use our gifts for the benefit of others. That's why God gives us gifts, not to keep them to ourselves and just benefit ourselves. Just it's to help others the way Joseph did. So Joseph had saved Egypt. Do you remember what Pharaoh did just in Thanksgiving because he was so thankful for Joseph's help? Do you remember? He made him his right hand and he made him the second in command. That is a great honor. He was not a slave anymore, and he was going to help Pharaoh, and he was going to help the land of Egypt for many years to come. So, but still, he was not with his family, and he missed his family a lot. So today, this Sunday, that's where the story ends. So we know that next Sunday, we're going to have the continuance of this story. And believe me, it's going to be amazing. But now we are going to read the story. And the story is called Field in Dreams. One night, some cows filled Pharaoh's dream. They went from plump to thin. He feared it meant more than it seemed, but tried to sleep again. To his dismay, he dreamt again, this time of dying grain. He tossed till he awoke and then yelled, "Someone help! Explain!" He called all of his wise men and magicians, everyone. "Please tell me what this means then." Their answers? There were none. Just then, A servant boy spoke up. Though squeaky was his voice, "I know I only bear your cup, but there is another choice."
"Go fetch this man," great Pharaoh said, and quickly it was done. Poor Joseph's heart was filled with dread. "Tell what my dreams mean, son."
The beads of sweat dried on his cheek. Relieved, young Joe did nod. "The meaning you ask me to seek won't come from me, but God." 7 years of crops galore, 7 years of none. Don't forget to save some for the lean years still to come.
For 7 years, Egyptians stored a part of all they grew. So when they couldn't gather more, they still had lots of food. Joe was glad that God called him to help folks far and wide. His dreamy talent lifted him from pit to Pharaoh's side.
And this story will continue next week. But now we're gonna do our craft. And our craft is very interesting today. So you have this. I want you to, well, after you color this, of course you can color this. This would be really, really awesome to color. After you color this, you're gonna open this like this. And you're gonna find four hooves. Do you know what hooves are? Well, yeah, they're the cow's legs. So you are going to, before you cut, because when you see those blue lines, you know that you're gonna cut eventually on those lines. But before you do, I'm gonna encourage you to color the hooves. Color them crazy. Color them like with crazy colors. Don't color them like boring brown or black. No, use your imagination. Use, I don't know, colors like green, blue, red. These could be fun hooves. So I am not gonna color them right now because it's gonna take too much of a time for the video, but you can use markers, crayons, color pencils, coloring pencils. Use whatever you have, which is good, and color your hooves. After you color them, you are going to cut them like this on the blue lines. You're going to cut across that blue line. Let me cut here. Okay, mine are cut. You cut them after you color them. And then you're gonna need either whatever you have at hand in your home. Either rubber bands. Oh, this one broke. Oh my God. If your rubber bands are old, don't use them. But, I always have plan B. So I have at hand also pipe cleaners. If you have pipe cleaners, or if you have 2 pieces of strand or 4 pieces of strand, you're gonna need four. Or 4 pipe cleaners, use them. Ribbons, whatever you have at hand. Ask mom or dad. After you do that, we are going to transform our hands and feet on to hooves. So we're going to do this. It's going to be kind of hard. You're going to need another person to help you here, especially if you have like ribbons or pipe cleaners. Help! So you get the idea, right? So you're going to see, now I have a hoof. So we're going to do the same in our hand, on our hands and our feet. After we do that, you're going to go to the third video. There are cows dancing. Yes, cows dancing. And we are going to dance to the tune or to the rhythm of the cows. So color your hooves, tie them like this. If you have rubber bands, it's easier. Make sure they're not old like pastors. And look for video number 3. Before you do that, let's close with a prayer. Repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for the surprising change in Joseph's life. Thank you for surprising ways we can help people too. Thank you for the gifts that you give us so that we can use them to make good things in the world. Amen. Go look for that third video and dance with the cows. Bye.